Yo guys, it's Absolute Nigga Pro here, and today I'm going to show you something exciting. Basically, do you know a long time ago that I did like a detect to see if the map is single player or multiplayer, and if the map was multiplayer, it would set all of the players in spectator mode and only the first player to adventure mode. Remember when I did that? The link is gonna be in the description if you don't remember it, but I did something else, and this time for 1.13, and this is much more precise, and you can customize it as you wish. Now, this is a function pack, a data pack, and you will be able to download this in the description. I'm gonna also try to upload it on Minecraft Maps. I don't know if they're gonna like something like that, but, you know, I live on the edge, so I'm gonna do it. Anyways, I'm going to show you how it works. It's really, really simple, but still, it's effective. If people don't know about commands and stuff like that, it will be really easier for them to, you know, create a system that works for multiplayer and another one that works for single player, so there are no glitches. And I use this in quite a lot of maps that I made. Okay, so let's start with the easiest one, okay? This is gonna detect if there is one player or more than one player in the game. So basically this is really straightforward. It will execute if there is no entity that is a player that has the tag first player. And if there is none, then it's gonna add to that entity the tag to one random entity the tag first player. So basically if there are no players and then one player joins, that player is gonna get the first player tag, okay? If a second player joins though, that second player is not gonna get the tag, because there is already a player that has the tag, so this is not gonna execute. Now it's gonna detect if there is a player that doesn't have the first player tag. So basically there are two players, because the first player is gonna always have the tag because of this command, the second player is always not gonna have the tag. So if there are two players, there is gonna be always one player that doesn't have the tag. And if one player doesn't have the tag, it's gonna say one player. Instead, if there is not a player that doesn't have the tag, then it's gonna say two players. Oh, whoops, I messed it up. It's the opposite, okay? If there is a player that doesn't have the first player tag, it's gonna say two players. If there isn't a player that doesn't have the first player tag, then it's gonna say one player. Kind of confusing, a little bit word rambling, but at least you get how it works. Now, if you're wondering what this system is, this is basically a scoreboard that detects every time you leave. So every time you leave, you get a score of 1 on the scoreboard. So when you leave, I will basically remove all of your tags, just in case, you know, someone quits and then joins again, and then it doesn't detect. But yeah, it removes all of their tags if they have the score of 1, and then resets their score. So if someone quits, it loses all of these tags, so it doesn't detect anymore. Now, since though I'm forever alone, and I don't have any players to test this with, I did an execute for entities. So basically this is exact same code, but instead of at A, there is at E, okay? So this works for entities, and as you can see, now I'm the only entity, so it's gonna say only one player. But if we take an armor stand, and we go like this, it's gonna say two or more players. If we do even more, it's gonna always say two or more players. But when all of these die, it's gonna say only one player, because it's only me. Now let's try and see the 1, 2, 3 or more entities detection. So yeah, it's the same thing with players, I just changed it from at all to at E. Just so, because I need it. And also here, first, on player that actually was at R, and now it is at E, leave it equals 1, sort equals random, that is the same exact thing. But basically, this is kind of similar to the one we did before. So it executes if there is not an entity called first player, and if there is not, it takes a random entity, and it adds the tag first player. Now it will do the same thing with second player though, because we also need to detect if there is a second player, because we have to go up to 3. So then it's gonna execute if there is already a first player entity, and if there is not a second player entity, then it's gonna add to everyone that doesn't have the first player tag, that has a limit of 1, so only 1, and randomly we're gonna add the second player. So what this means is, if there is already a first player with the first player tag, and if there is not a second player with the second player tag, then it's gonna add to the person that doesn't have the first player tag, the second player tag. Pretty confusing, I know, but, you know, rewind it a little bit of time so you're gonna understand it. And now it's pretty simple, we have to detect the three different options, so one player, two players, and three players. We're gonna detect them one by one. So first player means that there is only the entity with the tag first player, there are no other entities. So basically, this is pretty straightforward. We just detect, we always activate this, unless there are some entities that don't have the tag first player. So if there are some entities that don't have that tag, meaning that if there is any other entity, it's not gonna say one player. Two players is a little bit more complicated. We have to detect if an entity has the first player, then if there is another entity that has the second player, But then we also have to detect if there is an entity that doesn't have either first player or second player. So, you know, this is how we do it. First, it's this one. First we execute if there is an entity first player, then we execute if there is another entity that has attacked second player, because there have to be two players. And then, we do this command unless there is an entity that doesn't have either first or second player. So there are two players, two and not more, not less. Third players is really easy. So basically it's the same as this one, but instead of unless, there is an if. So we detect if there is an entity that has to tag first player, there is the entity that has to tag second player, and also there is an entity that has to tag that doesn't have either the first player nor the second player tag. So it's gonna be our third player. Now you could continue this and do it for three players, but then you have to do like exponentially more commands. So you know it's gonna be harder. But these are all the lines I've done. As you can see, if we do this, it's gonna say one player, two players, three more players, three or more players. So, you know, this works. Now, you cannot activate, like, all of the lines. Yeah, you could do this if you are, you know, crazy. But, you know, I don't recommend it. It's just gonna spam a little bit more. And as you can see, now it's gonna say one player and two players. Because, you know, these ones are detecting for players. So, it doesn't detect this armor stand. And these ones are detecting for entities. So, they detect the armor stand. This one says 2 plus because it stops at 2. And this one only says 2. If we add another entity, this is gonna keep saying 1. This is gonna keep saying 2 plus players. This is gonna keep saying 3 plus players. Now, this is not... That is not wrong, but, you know. Actually, I wanna do a little bit of a change. Instead of player, I wanna say entity. Because, you know, here I'm detecting entities, not players. But now I'm going to show you what I've done in a function pack. Because I put all of this in a function pack. And now I'm going to show you. So, if we go in detective single player, our save. And we go in data packs, multiplayer detective, data, multiplayer detective, functions. And we open up these files right here. So, we have the load file that will only load the scoreboard. And also set the command block output to false. So, it doesn't spam the chat. And also we have all of this code, okay, all of the code in green doesn't do anything, it's just me explaining, so don't worry about that. Now I just want to change a little bit of stuff. Here you go, entities, and here is entity. Okay, so now I fixed a lot of the code, I mean I just changed all of this here right here. So basically, do you know all of these commands that are right here? Okay, these four lines. Basically these four lines are divided like this. So this is the first line, this is the second one. This is the third, this is the fourth, and this is the detect if quit line. So basically, when it's green, it means that it's commented, so basically it's not gonna execute. And I'm saying here, I think instructions, only execute one at a time, because you know that's recommended. So as an example, if we wanna execute for one or two players in the game, as you can see, all of these lines are deactivated, but still it works, because the function is detecting one or one player or more in the game. But unfortunately, you know, I don't have more players. So we're gonna detect for entities to see if it works. So basically what you need to do is actually comment all of this beautiful code. So we go like this, and then we uncomment the one that we want to use. So we uncomment this one, this one, this one, and then we go. And now it should detect even for, you know, armor stands. So now it's gonna say one player still. I mean one entity. Yeah, this works. Nice. Awesome. And now we take an armor stand, we do this, two entities. And 2 plus, because you know I'm detecting only for 2 plus. So this works for every single, you know, case. And this is how you basically work it up. So as you can see, if you want to detect for like 1, 2, or 3 or more entities, just deactivate this one. I mean the comment that one, so activate it. And then, I'm gonna set this as default, because as I said up here, this one is default, so I'm gonna do this, and I'm gonna save it. Now, if you wanna change, naturally, the outcome, here, instead of one player, do you, for example, say, there is one player and there is one player in the game. So you can do whatever you want here. This is just a placeholder to say, yeah, there is one player. And yeah, that is it. Hope you learned something today. And also check it out if you want to see the code by yourself and actually use this in one of your maps. You don't need to worry about, you know, saying my name or anything. Yes, it's just a few commands. You don't need to credit me or anything. But still, it would be fun to see if you guys did any of this stuff in your maps and you needed any of this stuff in your maps. So I hope you really enjoyed this video. And what's really amazing to make, now I'm gonna compress the function and I'm gonna send it right over to you, and I'm gonna see you guys in the next video. Oh, by the way, if you wanna know how to, you know, put this function into use, just basically easy, I'm gonna give you this file right here, okay? You have to go in your saves folder, go here, go in Datapax and then paste this file right here, naturally uncompressed. So if you're wondering how to go in the save folder, it's pretty easy. Go in the word that you want, so for example this one, edit, open word folder, and you're right there. Then you just have to go in Datapax and then paste my Datapack. So yeah, that was it for today's video. Hope you really enjoyed it, and I'm gonna see you guys in the next one.